Welcome, husband. We knew in our hearts that you would find us. Come to Reso. Ambrosia and Amarissa must meet their father. Come, my love. Return to your family. far too much baggage. Far too much baggage.
Not right now.
Still composing?
Siren's Cove belongs to Mervale. Those butchering buccaneers sailed off that way. The ones that plundered my poor Mary Gull. 'Twould be poetic justice if they'd stopped off for a sing-along with Mervale's lovely daughters on their way home. Piety's raised Chevron's barricade. Not that I was likely to ever make the trip inland, but it was nice to have the dream. Hang on a moment. Got a stray thought seeking safe harbour. Piety's one to watch her own back, so she'd never cut off an escape route from possible trouble inland. The cunning witch must be able to lower that barricade from the other side, somehow. Marseilles commanded the southernmost of the Eternal Legions, here at Lion Eye's watch. Why was he called Lion Eye? Crazy fool had his left eye taken out and a golden-hued gem put in its place. His head must have made quite a pretty adornment for King Colm's belt.
Well, hello. While we live, we are blessed. This is the true face!
Why must men turn us into monsters? Far too much baggage. Duresso gave me the gem, kissed me. Promised that he would be by my side forever. I sang for him. I sang for Oriath with his gem at my throat. Kalisa's gem. Kalisa's voice. I sang in her echo, performing arias that had once made the Empire weep. I listened to Kalisa's lullabies in my dreams. I gave myself to her music, mind and body. Duresso left me for Scion with a promise to free me from Kalisa. I begged him not to go, tried to show him the wonder of my transformation, the beautiful daughters he would soon meet. He couldn't see. None of them could see. I fled from their hatred. When Duresso returns, I will cast his cure away. I will teach him what true love is.
Savagery thrives all around me.
thought you're a fool for seeking out Mervale. A fool in love with death. Now, I don't know. Still, you've delivered this coast from the terrors that long held sway here. We may now find some respite, and that's more than any of us could have hoped for. But please, consider this. What have you become when even nightmares fear you? Yes? Goodbye. Mm-hmm. Be well.
Far too much baggage.
That look in your eye. I recognize it. A survivor, just like Ina. That is my name, Exile, Ina. In my native tongue, it means lone fighter. That is what Ina was for many years. But it is dangerous.
I have seen many an exile come and go, into the forest or into the ground. You seem different somehow. Different good, different bad, it's hard to tell at this stage. The name is Eremir, and for now you have the benefit of my doubt. Those bandits you've encountered out there, they're the dregs of Oriath. And with any foul broth, the nastiest chunks bubble to the surface. The lords of Larceny, Oak, Creighton, and Alira, the self-appointed monarchs of the forest, Creighton in the east, Alira in the west, Oak in the north, and this village, this tribe, we pay their taxes. I would never venture to say that life in Rayclast is easy. But with those three gone, well, living here might just become... The end of learning is the beginning of death.
I am Grust. I hunt boar, hunt to feed my people. If you are not a friend to us, you'll need to run faster than boar.
This is our home. We hunt, we grow, we build. Your kind in the forest kill, steal, and burn. Soon they will take it all, leave us no food. Then we must move, leave our home.
They fall from trees, try to swarm over you like fleas. Their chieftain, stand back when he beats his chest. Bark is worse than bite. We are Asmeri, you are not. Eremir is not. Life was good when it was just Asmeri.
Anchoring for it, I embraced the patronage that High Templar Dominus offered my struggling museum. I took his favor and conducted his research into the thaumaturgical arts practiced within the Eternal Empire. I wish I'd known then what I know now, that I was pandering to the warped dreams of a madman. I've read about Chavron of Umbra and what she did to the Warden at Axiom. You did well to end Brutus's sorry existence. But Chavron's barricade, that's sad news indeed. There is little enough freedom in Rayclast as it is, but to be stranded on that dismal coast, I pity the exiles to come. Would I know how to lower the barricade? Afraid not. I was a bit distracted the last time I took the pass. Hungry goatmen to avoid on that side, Alira's thralls on this side. Grust is the strong right arm of this tribe. No man hunts better, and no man could do more to protect the ones he loves. The Asmeri. The culture that descended from the Asmerian Mountains and founded the Eternal Empire so long ago. Not that these people have any understanding of their lineage. Their history, identity, all but destroyed in the Cataclysm. These Asmiri took in a disowned son of Oriath, fed me, healed me. To repay my debt, I've taken in the orphans of a dead empire. Keep your wits up.
What troubles you bring? What do you want? Travel far. What? Return, if you must.
I am Yina, Keeper of the Spirit. Are you a kind exile, like Eremir? He is good to us, helps us. You will stay and help us too, yes? A beast hunts us in her dreams, a great white beast, tortured and maddened by bad men, a long time gone. She will come here one night to tear, crush and eat. Her pain tells her to. Find the white beast and end her pain before she shares it with us. The forest children are ill. Once they drank from fruit, ate nuts and berries. Now they drink blood. Eat brain and heart. This land is in a nightmare from which it cannot wake. Grust does what he thinks is right, and in Grust's dream, he is never wrong. Eremir was a wise man in Oriath. He is our wise man now. Hear him. You will learn much. If you do not hear, you will likely die. Be well.
You and me, we are the same. We dream big. We find new places. We do not tell stories. Stories are told about us. I learn the words, the ways of Oriath. You listen to me, and not pigheads like Grust. Then you will live to find more new places. The road? It runs east and west of here. To the west it passes the Bandit Woman's camp. Then turn south to the sea. But you say it is now blocked. I have seen a strange thing in the rock by that south pass. Like one of Grust's carvings, but of stone. You should go look at it. What has been closed might be opened again. Her fur, her skin, it remind me of biting winter. I see her one night, follow her to a cave in the old fields to the east. Listen to her howl at the stars. A sad, sad sound. Great white beast, she full of old pain. Grust is the big man in the tribe. All do what Grust says. But his spear goes limp when faced with the eight legs. Many exiles come this way. Eremir is not like them, not like you. He is an old man with many stories. He teaches us words that you can understand. He teaches we Asmiri to be strong, not in our arms and legs like Grust, strong in our heads. I like Yina. She thinks bigger than this place. She knows there is more to life than hunting and growing morka. There is spirit.
There's no resting on your laurels in Rayclast.
Thank you.
far too much baggage.
Make it fast. Return if you must. Greetings.
The white beasts. Silk knows more. There is land they threw to you.
Hello. Rocks and water. They move and live like monkey and viper. They die like monkey and viper too. There is no heart to see, but there is a heart to stab, if you can find it with your spear. Silk is no hunter. Silk scares children with stories at fire time. That eight leg he wears, he did not kill it. Found it in the forest, dead of age. I would like to see Silk face live eight-leg one day. See him wrapped up for lunch. Yina thinks she knows the spirit, that it talks to her. She talks to herself. Travel far.
Far too much baggage. far too much baggage.